This specimen demonstrated the ventricular system of the brain. This is lateral ventricle formed of, this is anterior horn, and this is body. This is posterior horn, and this is inferior horn. This triangular area at the junction between body, inferior and posterior horn is called trigon. We have two lateral ventricles, this is superior view. These two lateral ventricles are connected together with through a foramen. This foramen is called interventricular foramen. This is interventricular foramen, connecting it to this cavity. This cavity is called third ventricle. This one was the cavity of diencephalon or diencephalon. This cavity of the third ventricle, connected with the lateral ventricle through interventricular foramen of Monroe. So connection, this connection, interventricular foramen of Monroe connecting lateral ventricle with the third ventricle. And this third ventricle, lastly, this is a fourth ventricle. And this connection is called cerebral aqueduct of Sylvius, passing within the midbrain, this connection. So this is two lateral ventricles. This one is third ventricle, and this one is a fourth ventricle. Connection between lateral and third is called interventricular foramen of Monroe, this one. While connection between third and fourth through cerebral aqueduct. Regarding sagittal section of cerebrum, this on brain, this is cerebellum and this is brainstem. We have three parts, midbrain, pons, and medulla. And the cavity between pons, medulla, and cerebellum called fourth ventricle. It's triangular in shape in sagittal section. This segment is called midbrain, formed of two parts. The anterior part is called cerebral peduncle, while the posterior part is called tectum. This is tectum. And this is bones, this is anterior part, and this is posterior part. Anterior part is called basilar, posterior part is called tegmental. And this is medulla, it's formed of two parts. The upper part is called obmedulla, this upper part. And the lower part is called closed medulla. And it shows a canal called central canal passing through it, which is lined or marked now in this area. Also, this is the fourth ventricle. Bones, medulla, and cerebellum. Regarding the specimen of brainstem, if we look through this base of the brain, this is the brainstem, this is cerebellum, and this is medulla, and this bones. The midbrain is very short, shortest part of the brainstem, and is hidden. But we can remove it like this. This is midbrain, and this bones, and this is medulla, this is the anterior aspect. These are parts of the brain, this including diencephalon, and this area is called insula. Regarding this part, this is called crus cerebri of the midbrain, and this pons, this is basilar sulcus, and this is called middle cerebellar peduncle, connecting the pons with cerebellum. And lastly, this is medulla. We have anterior median fissure. This area is called olive. Medial to it, this called is area pyramid. And lateral this to elevation, like looks like olive, is inferior cerebellar peduncle connecting the medulla with the cerebellum. So we have three areas. This olive-like structure is olive, and medial to it pyramid, and lateral to it inferior cerebellar peduncle. And this is anterior median fissure passing through the medulla. This is the front of the medulla brainstem. Look to this space. This is called crus cerebri, which are parts of cerebral peduncle. The space in between them called interpeduncular fossa. Showing this projection is called infundibulum. This is infundibulum. Attached to the part, also lies in the interpeduncular fossa, is called tuber cinereum, and connecting it to the pituitary gland. This is the pituitary gland. Regarding the back of brainstem, we have what's called, this is a midbrain. The midbrain formed of four rounded elevations called colliculi, two superior colliculi and two inferior colliculi. The two superior colliculi related above to this gland is called pineal gland. And we have two inferior colliculi, and there is crociform sulcus in between. Looks like a cross. And from the midbrain, an extension pass of cerebellum called superior cerebellar peduncle. This is superior cerebellar peduncle. And lastly, we have the back of the bones and back of medulla. The back of bones and medulla form a diamond-shaped space, which is called floor of fourth ventricle. Regarding this specimen, Again, this is same of that. This is the back of midbrain. We have 3-4 colliculi, 4 elevations, and this 2 superior cerebellar peduncle. Regarding the medulla, back again, we have this fissure. It's called posterior median fissure or sulcus, passing the back of bones and medulla. Just lateral to it, this is called gracile tubercle. This is called gracile tubercle. And lateral to it is called cuneate tubercle. This area is called cuneate tubercle. Cuneate tubercle. And the most lateral is inferior cerebellar peduncle. This is inferior cerebellar peduncle. So we have gracile tubercle, cuneate tubercle, and the most lateral inferior cerebellar peduncle. The gracile tubercle is a continuation of the gracile tract. Cuneate tubercle is continuation of cuneate tract. And this is called floor fourth ventricle. Is formed of 2 parts. The lower part is called medullary part, belongs to open medulla. Upper part is called buntine part, belongs to the tegmental part of the bones. The boundaries, these are 2 inferior cerebellar peduncles below, and above 2 superior cerebellar peduncles above.